Why does quantum tech need to be introduced to drones, Niccolo?
Well, it's part of our broader field, actually, of driving the quantum internet and our full solutions of quantum computing, quantum networking, and quantum sensing into every theater. So we have quantum sensors that work on submarines for inertial navigation and on ships on the top of the ocean. We, of course, have quantum networks and quantum computers on the land, and we're building quantum economies in various jurisdictions and states around the world. And of course, we've also got our satellite signals intelligence business up in space. And so drones were the missing piece of the four theaters, where we now have quantum networking, quantum computing, and quantum sensors in partnership with Heven up in the air.
What will it help Heven do? And why are you going with Heven when it's still undergoing field evaluation with the US military?
Well, look, it's a partnership that is fantastically pioneering given the range of their drones. They're hydrogen powered. Obviously, this doesn't prohibit us from broadening out our engagement with the drone ecosystem. At the same time, you know, they're very tech forward as an organization. And so we love the fact that they want to pioneer with us quantum networking communications between drones in their fleet. They want to work with us on our quantum computers to help, you know, not only coordinate their fleet, but also enact surveillance and early signal detection using our computers in conjunction with satellite imagery that we can provide, plus, of course, imagery that they can provide. And then last but not least, of course, they're interested in embedding our quantum sensors and positioning navigation and time advances and technologies into their drone platform. So, you know, where there's a will, there's a way, right? And the reality is we consider ourselves to be a pioneering company, 30 years in the making. We have led every aspect of quantum computing, quantum networking, and quantum sensing for 30 years. We were the first public company in the space, the first machines that turned on, the first machines on the public cloud. And today we're extending that capability to another theater, which we find tremendously exciting.
They're, of course, pioneering in hydrogen. You're saying you're pioneering by being first public company really focused on quantum. But what actually are you doing for your partners right now, Niccolo? Many understand the promise of quantum, but you say you're in the field with IonQ Forte, with IonQ Forte Enterprise. You're already working with AWS, with AstraZeneca, NVIDIA. But you sort of say you're achieving 20x performance results. Performance results of what?
Yeah, so the AstraZeneca partnership that you're referring to is, I think, the most powerful example of what we call quantum advantage that's ever been generated in history. And so IonQ is proud of the fact that we have pioneered every aspect of the quantum revolution, both commercially and in the lab. We're the first company to achieve what's called four nines of fidelity, 99.99% fidelity, which means that our qubits are the best in the world and the highest quality, and they're the most powerful. And so the 20x speedup is turning almost a month of classical computation using a GPU data center into just a day and a half. And in fact, if you double click on that outcome, we actually have portions of the problem that we sped up by 656 times. The classical portions of the workflow obviously kind of bring down the average, but nevertheless, it's a tremendous example of what we're achieving in the pharmaceutical, the health tech space, if you will, using our Forte Enterprise systems. Yeah. Now, our new computer that we just announced 2 months ago on September 12th, Tempo, is 260 million times more powerful than Forte. And so you can imagine that we'll be turning not just a month of computation into a day and a half, but we aspire to turn a year of classical computation into a day and a half on our newest machine.
We've only got a minute left, but you talk about how you were the first really pioneering into the public markets, Niccolo. Public markets are full of anxiety right now. I just shine a light on your own share price, which I think is down about 47% from its high that we had up in October. How is that riding that roller coaster briefly?
Well, look, when I say pioneering, it wasn't just the public markets. We actually invented the quantum computing category back in 95 when we demonstrated the world's first qubit gate at the University of Maryland. And we've pioneered every milestone since then, both in the lab and commercially. And so being a public company, we consider to be a natural part of our evolution. Yeah. You know, we raised $3 billion between July and October.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, honestly been part of establishing the sector, our communications opportunities around the world, and ultimately credibility that enables us to drive both government traction and private sector commercial traction. So we're
great to catch up with you, Niccolo. I have to leave it there. Niccolo de Masi, thank you.